Okay, this episode is tied in with, is connected to the previous episode, the mind-body-nature-social connection. As I mentioned, it should be used as a motivator. These four things should ideally be happening together as it did for hunter-gatherer man. Your social connection, your exercise, and you're out in nature, you're using your mind and your body simultaneously. And this is how we are meant. We are hardwired genetically to experience this in unison, together, not separately. Now, for as far as aging is concerned, and the aging human body, one of the reasons we're aging so poorly is because we're not using the mind and body together. We're not out in nature enough. We're not socializing enough. And you look at the studies on Alzheimer's. There's a plane up above here. You look at the Alzheimer's studies and the dementia studies about the plaquing and tangling diseases of the brain, the dementias, and isolation, lack of exercise. In fact, exercise has been shown to be the number one way to prevent dementia. So, people isolated, they're sitting in nursing homes, they're not exercising, they're not out in nature enough. If they're lucky, they get out on the patio in their wheelchair or whatever their situation is. And the mind-body connection is not there because they're not using their body. They may be thinking, if they're still capable of thinking, but properly. But you need all four. So if you want to age in a healthy manner, you have to combine these. And modern society is interesting in that you listen to the psychiatrist and the psychologist, they say, well, that the sign of a healthy, balanced person is a person who has balance in their lives. They have their family life, their work, etc. Well, the truth of the matter is, society doesn't give you a balanced life. You go to a cubicle 8 hours a day in many cases. You do some repetitive task over and over in a factory. You don't socialize in the same way. You're away from nature. So the bottom line is, you have to go out and create balance the healthy way. Not the way society tells you to do it. Sitting in a cubicle, a repetitive task all day long in a factory, lack of socializing in nature, in a nature setting, on and on. It doesn't exist to the degree it needs to for a person to have balance. Just exercise alone. People don't exercise. That's huge. There is the mind-body connection already being disrupted from our genetic, hardwired genetics from our ancestors. This is just reality, and I'm adamant about this, and it's so obvious to me, but it's not obvious to our society, because we just fall into complacency and we just follow the herd. Okay, that's all I have to say about those two subjects or those episodes.